So last night IIT Bombay released the answer key along with the actual question paper. If you have not checked the answer key yet and if you are unable to figure out how to check the right answer key, then you can simply go to the website of GATE 2021. Here you need three things. Number one is the actual response sheet that you have downloaded from the websites a few weeks ago. After downloading the response sheet, what you have to do is you have to go to the website and you have to check the latest update regarding the actual question paper and the answer key. Download that actual question paper along with the answer key and match with your response sheet. So you need three things. Number one is your response sheet, the actual question paper and the answer key. And now talking about my own marks and score, I have scored 52 marks out of 100 without negative marking. And now if I subtract the negative marking and all the wrong questions from 52 marks, then my score comes down to 50 marks out of 100. Only 4 to 5 questions with negative marking went wrong for me. As I was very conscious about the negative marking, that's why my score went from 52 to 50 marks only. A few students have called me and told me that they have done negative marking of 7 to 8 marks. They are disappointed that they have marked so many wrong questions in the examination, and due to this their marks have been reduced by 7 to 8 marks. As we have seen in UGC NET examination, the cutoff lies always between 50 to 55%. This UGC NET examination does not have negative marking, but whereas our GATE examination had negative marking. So if your score is around 40 marks out of 100, then you can feel safe. And now here are the two questions that I am going to challenge. According to the original question paper that was released yesterday, these two questions are question number 7 and question number 9 from section B, reasoning and comprehension. Question number 7 is X-ray examination of a recently discovered painting that some authorities judge to be self-portrait. The answer I marked several painted canvas that art historians attribute to Michelangelo contain under images that appear on at least one other of Michelangelo's painting. This answer is wrong according to the GATE answer key, which I think can be challenging. The question number 9 is about the reordering of the sentences from 1 to 5 such that they form a paragraph. The answer I marked was 2, 3, 1, 4, 5. Many languages are failing and are being replaced by others that are more widely in the region or nation, such as English in Australia or Portuguese in Brazil. Many other languages are no longer being learned by new generations of children or by new adult speakers. Also, let me know what do you think about the question from English literature which talks about the novel Story Within a Story with multiple narratives. According to GATE, the right answer is Wuthering Heights and Joseph Conrad's Heart of Darkness. I have read the actual text of these two works, and no doubt Wuthering Heights have multiple narratives, but as I read Joseph Conrad's Heart of Darkness, I found the narrative straightforward without any introduction of another narrative. The only narrator of Heart of Darkness was Marlowe, and yes, Joseph Conrad has used the technique of delayed decoding, but still I am unable to figure out the multiple narrator in this work Heart of Darkness. Maybe I am wrong. Correct me in the comments below. Also, you can use the comment section below to discuss with me the question paper. We still have 3 to 4 days to challenge the answer key. The earlier you will check the answer key, the sooner you will be able to figure out the wrong answer that might be challenged. So we have only 3 to 4 days to challenge the answer key. So let me know about the wrong questions that you think can be challenged. Also, let me know about your marks in the comments below. This will help us to predict the GATE results. So that's it for this video. I hope you found the video worth of your time. If you're new to this channel and have not subscribed to this channel yet, then don't forget to subscribe the channel for more updates on English literature. So that's it for this video. Thank you.